You didn't need to buy a ticket to Kentucky Kingdom to go on a roller coaster today. All you had to do is watch the final round of the Open Championship. Just when it seemed Jordan Spieth was going down, he came back up with a performance of a lifetime. Let's head back across the pond. Spieth ended the day with a three-shot lead by hole 13. It was all but gone. Take a look at this tee shot. Spieth knew it was not good the moment he left his club. Lands about 100 yards to the right of the fairway. He'd bogey the hole, end up a stroke back of Matt Kuchar for the lead. Spieth wasn't done, though. Came back with a birdie to tie it on 14. Then on 15, that is an eagle. Spieth back. He's got the lead. Kuchar, meanwhile, staying alive on 17. Birdie. Boom. Kuchar, only one shot back. But Spieth would not let him get any closer. Birdie 17 to go up two. Then on 18, finishes with a par for a three-shot win. Spieth wins the Open Championship, and he does it the hard way. He says the turning point today ironically came when all looked lost.
I felt once I lost my lead completely and we were tied, I actually felt the nerves go away for a few holes until I got the lead again, and then they were back. You just don't know really what your mind's going to do to you sometimes. You can control it to an extent, but certain situations are going to bring more tension, and that was a difficult thing to do today because it was just so up and down.
Well, that heart from Spieth, who joins Jack Nicklaus as the only players to win three different majors at age 23. From golf now to swimming, a couple of Cardinals added to their medal collection today, and in the process, added their names to the U.S. record books. Happened at the FINA World Championships today from Budapest. U of L swimmers Mallory Comerford and Kelsey Worrell, part of the U.S. 4x100 team. Comerford in lane four actually lost the first leg of the race, but only after a world record was set by a swimmer from Sweden. Comerford set an American record with a time of 52.59 in the leadoff spot. Worrell swam the third leg and finished with a time of 53.16. There you see in the circle. The American team, which also featured Katie Ledecky and Simone Manuel, would go on to win the race, taking the gold and setting a new American record in the process with a time of 3:31.72. Afterward, Comerford spoke about the victory.
I was just so excited to race with these girls, and I'm so proud of them and so glad we brought that back to the USA.
The FINA World Championships continues all week. Well, switching up to basketball, it has been the perfect weekend to catch up with old friends in Lexington. Former Wildcat Julius Randle there yesterday to host camp. Karl-Anthony Towns doing the same today. Towns coming back home means having to deal with, what could have been. It's been 2 years since he and the Wildcats came up short at a championship and a perfect season. Towns admits that's still hard to swallow, but when it comes to the legacy of that team, he says the team is still special because of the way they played the game.
You're going to look back at and see our team as a testament to what true power is and what true perfection is, but at the same time, how far away perfection truly could be in a humbling story, which is sad because I felt our story was written in pen instead of pencil.
Town's getting poetic there. I like it. Well, from something deep to something light. Not sure if you guys know this, but the drive-by dunk challenge is a thing. Basically, you go in your car, you drive up to some random hoop, and then you just, throw one down. Kids are doing it, NBA players are doing it, and now a certain coach from Kentucky is doing it as well. That in the shadows is John Calipari, and that is the UK coach doing his part to keep the trend going. Not the best of dunks, but I like the effort. There's still much more to come tonight in sports. Reds looking for only their second victory in 10 games. Up next, how they showed the Marlins some fight in more ways than one. Yeah. The Cincinnati Reds are 17 games below 500, and I think it's safe to say the losing is starting to get to everyone. And I'm not just talking about the players or manager Brian Price. Watch this. This was during today's game with the Marlins. Miami's D. Gordon trying to be nice to a Reds fan who was not having any of it. He kicked him right in the shin, and it hurt. Reds perhaps inspired by that fight, showing fight of their own in this one. That's Scooter Jeanette doing his thing in the fourth, 17th of the season. It broke a 1-1 tie. Suddenly the brakes starting to go Cincinnati's way. Fifth inning, looked like Joey Votto was grounding into a double play. Instead, ball gets away. Run scores. Reds up 3-1. They weren't done. Sixth inning, a little more power. First, Eugenio Suarez with the solo shot. Then, Two batters later, Tucker Barnhart. Boom. Reds take this one by the final of 6-3. Only the second victory for them in 10 games. They're set to make a nice 11-game road trip tomorrow.
We have the ability, I think, here to win enough games to feel like we're moving in the right direction and, kind of digging ourselves out of the hole that we've created.
Reds back to it tomorrow against Cleveland. In the minors, Spats looking to split a four-game series with the Bisons. Bottom one, Louisville down one. Jesse Winker doing some damage. Single scores in Tyler Goodell. That tied up the game at one. Bats would fall behind 4-1 in this one. Occasionally, we'd see some signs of life. Sebastian Elizalde blast to left in the fifth. Louisville cutting the lead in half, but they would get no closer. Ninth inning, wild pitch here from Ariel Hernandez. Jake Elmore scores. The Bisons would go on to win by the final of 5-2. They take 3 of 4 from Louisville this weekend. Back to basketball, the All-In Hoop Fest wrapped up at the Kentucky Fair and Expo Center today. IU head coach Archie Miller made an appearance earlier. Got a chance to watch commit Jerome Hunter in action. Hunter and his team OH Nova taking on the Louisville Magic in the U-17 championship game. Hunter showing off his stuff here in the first half off the steal. He's going to take in for the dunk. Hunter doing his part, but his team trailed by 9 at the half, and they got worse in the second. Ashton Miles devoured the nice dish to Omar Keita for the dunk. Louisville Magic won easily, but Hunter still impressive in the loss. He talked about picking IU after the game.
Well, me and Coach Miller already had a relationship from Dayton. And so when he went there, I went up there for a little bit before team camp. Had a quick little visit. I love the campus. The style of play he had was great. And I mean, everything was just great about Indiana.
Are you going to be happy to have him? Before we go, NASCAR today, they weren't too far from here. They were at the Brickyard. Kyle Busch hoped to make history and become the first Cup driver to win 3 straight in Indy. Busch did a good job. He won the first 2 stages, but in lap 111, took a turn for the worse. Banged Martin Truex Jr. Both cars sustained heavy damage. Truex Jr.'s car on fire. Both cars were okay. No history, though, for Busch. This one just filled with crashes and cautions. Ended up going to OT. 2 laps left to go. Another caution, Denny Hamlin getting loose, but the good news is, before that happened, Kasey Kahne crossed the finish line, passing Brad Keselowski. Kasey Kahne gets a big win today in Indy. And that is it for sports. I'm Mike Lissette. Tom Lane will be right back here with you tomorrow night. I'll have a great story on a guy that sings the national anthems at Louisville Bats games. You do not want to miss that one.